If SU2 and U1 are subgroups of a larger group, then the ratio of the couplings G1 and G2 is determined. That means that the weak mixing angle theta W is no longer a free parameter to be fixed by experiment. Since theta W is well measured, obtaining the correct value is a strong constraint on any attempt at unifying SU2 and U1. For the SU5 unification, there are two parts of the calculation. First, the symmetry structure enters, but that determines sine squared theta W where the symmetry holds, at the unification scale. Then to see what sine squared theta W is at the weak scale, we have to express sine squared theta W in terms of the couplings. The SU5 prediction is that sine squared theta W equals 3/8. We see that sine squared theta W has changed from 3/8 at the unification scale to about 0.21 at the weak scale. To understand why sine squared theta W changes, that is, why the couplings change differently, it is necessary to draw the diagrams that leads to alpha 1 and alpha 2. SU5 has 24 gauge bosons that occur in the loops. Since only 8 gluons plus W plus C plus gamma equals 12 of them are observed, the others must be heavy, and, as minus Q squared decreases, they no longer contribute importantly to the loops. The loop contributions that become unimportant leave different numerical values for alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha 3. The prediction is a strong constraint on possible guts. By 1982, the calculations had been performed for a supersymmetric SU5 gut, giving a value of 0.23. With the precision measurements at lab, the experimental value moved to the supersymmetric gut value, to within the measured accuracy of 1% of the value.